in today's lecture we will discuss consistency of system of linear equations. We have studied rules to solve a system of non-homogeneous system of linear equations, and we have solved problems related with all the rules, whether we will get unique solution, we will get infinitely many solutions, or we will get no solution. So we have practiced all the three types of cases. Now I take a different type of problem in which, in this question, a system of linear equation is given. The system is x plus y plus z equal to 6, x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 10, x plus 2y plus lambda z equal to mu. Here in this system, these two symbols, lambda and mu, these are unknowns. And the question is like this, that we have to find the values of lambda and mu. So the question is, find the values of lambda and mu so that the given system may have, number one, a unique solution, number two, may have infinitely many solutions. More than one solution. Third, may have no solution. So in this question, we have to find the values of lambda and mu so that this system may have a unique solution, this system may have infinitely many solutions, no solution. So for that, we proceed as usual. First, we calculate the augmented matrix. So we write the augmented matrix of the system. The augmented matrix will be 1, 1, 1, 6, 1, 2, 3, 10, 1, 2, lambda, mu. Next, so this is the augmented matrix of the given system of linear equation. We denote it by A slash T. Now we will try to find the rank of this augmented matrix, and for that we will convert this into an upper triangular form. For that we concentrate on the principal diagonal. In the principal diagonal, on 1-1 position we have 1. So we decide operations R2 replaced by R2 minus R1 and R3 replaced by R3 minus R1, so that we may have 0 at the two positions of the first column. So below this 1-1 position of this augmented matrix, we want to create 0 to have an upper triangular form. So for that, we have decided these two operations. So if we will apply these two operations on the above mentioned augmented matrix, then we will get this matrix. The first row will remain same, second row will be replaced by R2 minus R1, 1 minus 1, 0, 2 minus 1, 1, 3 minus 1, 2, 10 minus 6, 4. Next, we will replace third row by R3 minus R1. So, at the third row place, we will have 0, 1, lambda minus 1, and mu minus 6. So in this way, we have created 0 below the 1-1 position. Next, we will try to create 0 below the 2-2 position. So, for that, we apply R2 minus R3 replaced by R3 minus R2. So that we may have 0 below the 2-2 position. So, we want to create 0 here. After applying this operation, the first row will remain same and second row will also remain unchanged. The third row will change. So, third row will be 0, 0, lambda minus 3 and mu minus 10. So, in this way, we have converted the given Euclidean matrix into the upper triangular form. Now, from here we can decide the values of lambda and mu for which the given system will have unique solution. So, we will be able to decide the values of lambda and mu for which the system will have a unique solution, will have many more solutions, infinitely many solutions, and will have no solution. For that, we need to concentrate on the last upper triangular form. In the last upper triangular form, if we concentrate on these two positions, where the entries are lambda minus 3 and mu minus 10, then according to the 0 and non-zero values of lambda minus 3 and mu minus 10, we will have different ranks of the Euclidean matrix and the coefficient matrix. So, we study all types of cases, all types of possibilities. So, we can write first case lambda not equal to 3, mu not equal to 10. Second case lambda not equal to 3, but mu is equal to 10. Third case lambda is equal to 3, mu is equal to 10. Fourth case lambda is equal to 3, but mu is not equal to 10. So, there will be no other possibility for the 0 and non-zero values of lambda minus 3 and mu minus 10. Now, under all the cases, we try to decide whether the rank of the Euclidean matrix will be equal to the rank of the coefficient matrix or not. So, we observe that in first case, when lambda is not equal to 3, mu is not equal to 10, then lambda minus 3 and mu minus 10 both will be non-zero. So, rank of the Euclidean matrix will be 3 and the rank of the coefficient matrix. The rank of the coefficient matrix can be obtained by hiding this last fourth column. So, if we hide this fourth column, then we get the coefficient matrix. And we observe that if lambda is not equal to 3, if lambda minus 3 is non-zero, then the coefficient matrix will have a rank equal to 3. There will be 3 non-zero rows. So, the rank of the coefficient matrix will also be equal to 3. So, in this case, as per the rules of consistency of non-homogeneous system of linear equation, we will have a unique solution. Further, if we move towards second case, when lambda is not equal to 3, mu is equal to 10. So, lambda minus 3 is non-zero, however, mu minus 10 is 0. So, because lambda minus 3 is non-zero, so the rank of the Euclidean matrix will remain 3. Because this position, the third row will be a non-zero row. Next, we go to the coefficient matrix. Now, if mu is equal to 10 and lambda is not equal to 3, in that case also the coefficient matrix will have rank equal to 3. So, in both the cases, when lambda is not equal to 3 and mu is not equal to 10 or mu is equal to 10, in both the cases we will have rank of Euclidean matrix equal to 3 equal to rank of A, where this common number 3 is equal to the number of variables of the problem. In this problem, we have 3 number of variables. So, that is why in both the cases, we will have a unique solution. So, we can write here that whenever lambda will not be equal to 3 and mu may take any value. In this case, the system will have a unique solution. Whenever lambda will not be equal to 3 and mu can be arbitrary number, then the system will have a unique solution. Now we go to third case. In the third case, lambda is equal to 3, mu is equal to 10. So at these two positions we will have 0. So the third row will be 0. So for both the coefficient matrix and the augmented matrix, the rank will come equal to 2. So the rank of the coefficient matrix will be 2 because this is 0 and mu minus 10 is also 0. So the rank of the augmented matrix will be 2 and rank of the coefficient matrix will also be 2. That we can decide after hiding the fourth column. Because lambda is equal to 3, so here we will have 0. So third row will be 0. So the rank of the coefficient matrix will be 2. So according to the rules of consistency of non-homogeneous system, whenever the rank of the augmented matrix is equal to the rank of the coefficient matrix and this common number, which is here 2 in this case, if this common number is less than the number of unknowns, number of variables, which is 3 in this question, so in that case we will have infinitely many solutions. So this situation corresponds to the second case, infinitely many solution case. So we will have more than one solution when lambda is equal to 3 and mu equal to 10 for the given system of linear equation. Now we move towards the third case. In the third case, lambda will be equal to 3, mu is not equal to 10. So here at lambda minus 3 we will have 0, and in place of mu minus 10 we will have a non-zero number. Now if you observe in this case, in the last case, fourth case, the rank of the augmented matrix will be equal to 3 because this mu minus 10 is non-zero. So we will have a third non-zero row also. So rank of the augmented matrix will be 3, but the rank of the coefficient matrix will be 2 because lambda minus 3 is 0. So because of lambda equal to 3 situation, the rank of the coefficient matrix will be 2. So we observe that here in fourth case, the rank of augmented matrix is not equal to the rank of the coefficient matrix. So as per the rules of the consistency of non-homogeneous system of linear equation, in this case the system will have no solution. So this fourth case, when lambda equal to 3 and mu not equal to 10, will correspond to the third case of no solution. Clear? So we can, in this way, if we have a system of linear equation involving some unknowns, lambda, mu, or we may use symbol small a, small b, then we can decide the values of these unknown symbols so that the system may have a unique solution, may have many solutions, may have no solution. Next, I will discuss homogeneous system of linear equations. The rules for the non-homogeneous system of linear equations are little bit different than the non-homogeneous systems. And homogeneous system, solving homogeneous system will also be useful while calculating eigenvectors in the next chapter. So we will be using homogeneous the solutions of homogeneous system or linear equation frequently. So I mention here homogeneous system of linear equations, and we have discussed the meaning of homogeneous system of linear equation. The meaning of homogeneous system of linear equation is, can be explained by this example. If I write a system of linear equation of this form, a1x plus b1y plus c1z equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2z equal to 0, a3x plus b3y plus c3z equal to 0. Then we observe that if we convert this system of linear equation into one matrix equation, then we will have A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3 as a coefficient matrix, and we will have a variable vector x, y, z equal to, now the right hand side column vector will have 0 at all the places. So in the right hand side column vector will be 0 vector in this case. So that is why this system is homogeneous system of linear equation. So we first we need to, whenever we have a system of linear equation, first we need to identify whether the given system of linear equation is homogeneous or not. For that we check the right hand side column vector. If all the entries of the right hand side column vector are 0, then the system will be homogeneous system. And if any one of the entries of the right hand side column vector is non zero, then the system will be non homogeneous. Now I will give you the rules to solve the homogeneous system of linear equations. So when a system is homogeneous, then in that case obviously the Eugmented matrix, the rank of the Eugmented matrix will always be equal to the rank of the coefficient matrix. That is why homogeneous system, every homogeneous system is always consistent. And so every homogeneous system will always have a solution, and that solution is the zero solution. So if you will take x, y, z, all the variables of the system equal to 0, then this 0 solution will always satisfy every homogeneous system of linear equation. So this is 0 solution or trivial solution. Besides this, in some cases we may have non-zero solutions also. In some cases we may have non-zero solutions for the homogeneous system of linear equation. Now I will give you the conditions under which a given homogeneous system will have a zero solution only or will have non-zero solutions also. So remember, in second case the zero solution will also be there, but in addition to that some non-zero solution will also exist. So for first case, the condition will be like this, that the rank of the coefficient matrix, the rank of the coefficient matrix will be equal to the n, the number of variables of the system. So if we calculate, so in case of homogeneous system there is no need to write the Eugmented matrix. So we will write the coefficient matrix and we will try to calculate the rank of the coefficient matrix, and if we find that the rank of the coefficient matrix is equal to the number of variables, then we will conclude that the system will have only zero solution, and there will be this case, zero solution case corresponds to unique solution case of the non-homogeneous system. Next, if we calculate the rank of the coefficient matrix, and if we observe that the rank is less than n, the number of variables of the system, in that case the system will have non-zero solutions also. So this case corresponds to infinitely many solution case of the non-homogeneous system. And as I have mentioned, homogeneous system will always be consistent, so there will not be the third case of no solution in this situation. So homogeneous system will always have a solution, and that solution will be zero. So what we will decide for homogeneous system will be that whether the system will have only zero solution, that will correspond to this equation. When rank of the coefficient matrix will be equal to the number of variables. And second, when the system, in which case the system will have a non-zero solutions also, that case will correspond to the this condition, when rank of the coefficient matrix will be less than the number of variables. I will take example for both the cases. Before that, I want to add few useful additional conditions in terms of determinants of the matrix. So we have studied the idea of rank. If the rank of the coefficient matrix is equal to n, this means that the determinant of A will be non-zero. And if the rank of the coefficient matrix is less than n, then in this case the determinant of A will be zero, provided our coefficient matrix is a square matrix. Only in that case we will be able to calculate determinant. So whenever the coefficient matrix of a given homogeneous system is a square matrix, then we can use these ideas of calculating determinant. So when the determinant of the coefficient matrix will be zero, then there will be the possibility of non-zero solution also. And when the determinant of the coefficient matrix will be non-zero, then the homogeneous system will have only zero solution. So to illustrate these two conditions, I take two examples. Number one example is a system of linear equation given in this form: x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 0, 3x plus 4y plus 4z equal to 0, 7x plus 10y plus 12z equal to 0. So in this question we have a system of homogeneous, we have a homogeneous system of linear equations, and the question is decide whether the system will have a zero solution or will have some non-zero solutions also. And if there are non-zero solutions, then try to calculate those solutions. So for that, what we will do, we will construct the coefficient matrix of the given system. So the coefficient matrix of this system of linear equation will be this: 1, 2, 3, first row will be 1, 2, 3, second row will be 3, 4, 4, and third row will be 7, 10, 12. Now we try to calculate the rank of this coefficient matrix. For that, we convert this matrix into upper triangular form, and for that we decide row operations. So here we need to apply R2 replaced by R2 minus 3R1, so that we may have 0 below the 1-1 position, because at the 1-1 position we already have 1, so we can decide these operations very easily to have 0 below the 1-1 position. And R3 will be replaced by R3 minus 7R1 to have 0 at the 3-1 position, to have 0 in place of 7. So if we will apply these operations, then we will get a new matrix equivalent to the coefficient matrix in the sense of rank. So we calculate all the entries. In the second row, we will replace second row by R2 minus 3R1. So minus 6 plus 4 minus 2, and minus 9 plus 4 minus 5. Here in the third row case, minus 7 into 2 minus 14 plus 10 minus 4, and minus 21 plus 12 will be equal to minus 9. Minus 21 plus 12 will be equal to minus 9. So we are getting this, you may take this form of the coefficient matrix. Now we will try to create 0 below the 2-2 position. So for that, we need to apply R2 replaced by R2 minus, R3 replaced by R3 minus 2R2. Because at 2-2 position we have minus 2. So when we will multiply it with minus 2, we will have 4. And adding the result in the minus 4, we will get 0. So we apply this operation to have 0 below the 2-2 position. So first row will remain same, 1, 2, 3. And second row will also remain unchanged, 0, minus 2, minus 5. Third row will change. So minus 2 into minus 5, 10, minus 9, 1. So we get the upper tabular form of the coefficient matrix. Now we observe that we have obtained upper tabular form, which is also an SLN form. So the rank of the coefficient matrix will be equal to 3, which is equal to the number of variables of the system, which is equal to number of variables of the system. Therefore, the system will have only 0 solution. So this case will correspond to first, the 0 solution case. So this system of linear equations which is homogeneous will have only 0 solution. So there will be only one solution for this system, and that solution will be x equal to y equal to z equal to 0. No other non-zero solution will exist for this system. We can also solve this problem by calculating the determinant of the coefficient matrix. If you will calculate the determinant of the coefficient matrix, then you will find that the determinant will be not zero. So from that case also, you can decide that this homogeneous system will have only zero solution. Next, we take one more example to cover the second case also. So this time our system of linear equation is x plus 3y minus 2z equal to 0, 2x minus y plus 4z equal to 0, x minus 11y plus 14z equal to 0. Of course, the given system is a homogeneous system of linear equation. So to decide whether the system will have a zero solution or non-zero solution, we write the coefficient matrix and we denote it by A. So the coefficient matrix will be 1, 3, minus 2, 2, minus 1, 4, 1, minus 11, 14. Our next step will be to calculate the rank of this coefficient matrix. So for that, we apply raw operations R2 minus 2R1, means we will replace the second row R2 by R2 minus 2R1 and R3 minus R1 operation. So we will replace the third row by R3 minus R1. We have decided these operations, these raw operations, to have 0 below the 1-1 position, so that we may get the upper tabular form. So we calculate it. The first row will remain unchanged, 1, 3 minus 2. Second row can be calculated in this way, minus 2 plus 2, 0, minus 6, minus 1, minus 7, and 4 plus 4, 8. R3 minus R1 can be calculated in this way, 1 minus 1, 0, minus 11 minus 3, minus 14 and 14 plus 2, 16. Next, we have minus 7 at the 2-2 position. So, we try to create 0 below the 2-2 position. At 2-2 position, we have minus 7. So, now we apply R3 minus 2R2. So, we will replace the third row by R3 minus 2R2. So, that we may have 0 here. So, that we may have the upper triangular form. Now, if we apply these operations, then we observe that we get this matrix. The first row will remain same, 1, 3 minus 2. The second row will also remain unchanged, 0, minus 7, 8. But the third row will be 0, 0, 0. So, if you will apply R3 minus 2R2 operation, then we will have third row 0. So, in this way, we have converted the given coefficient matrix into an upper triangular form, and it is an SLN form also. So, the rank of the coefficient matrix, so the rank of the coefficient matrix will be equal to 2, the number of non-zero rows in the upper triangular or SLN form. So, we observe that the rank of the coefficient matrix is 2, which is less than 3, the number of variables of the system. Number of variables of the system are 3, and the rank of the coefficient matrix is 2, which is less than the number of variables. So, the system will have non-zero solutions also. We can also decide this fact by calculating the determinant of the coefficient matrix. When you will calculate determinant of the coefficient matrix for this question, for this system, then the determinant will be equal to 0. So, that will also indicate the existence of non-zero solutions. But if we want to actually calculate those non-zero solutions, then this rank method will be very helpful. Because in this rank method, this upper triangular form will give us the non-zero solution directly. Otherwise, if we will decide the case of non-zero solution by calculating determinant A equal to 0, in that case, to find those non-zero solution, we will need to calculate this upper triangular form at the end. So, whenever we need to find a non-zero solution in case of homogeneous system, then it will be useful, it will be helpful to follow this rank method also. And in questions where we only need to decide the cases, whether the system will have zero solution or will have non-zero solutions also, and if we do not want to calculate the actual solutions, then these determinant conditions will be very helpful, because we can the calculations of determinant will reduce all these three steps to a single step. So, next we proceed to find the solutions of this homogeneous system. As we have decided that the system will have non-zero solutions also. Zero solution will always satisfy a given homogeneous system. But here in this case, we have observed that the rank of the coefficient matrix is 2, which is less than the number of variables. So, we should have non-zero solutions. Now, what will be those non-zero solutions? We can calculate those non-zero solutions by converting the last upper triangular form of the coefficient matrix into a corresponding homogeneous system of linear equations. So, I convert the last upper triangular form of the coefficient matrix into the equations. So, we will get equations x plus 3y minus 2z equal to 0. Second equation will be minus 7y plus 8z equal to 0. Now, here we get only two equations, and we have to decide the values of three variables. So, we have to find the values of three variables, and we have only two restrictions. We have only two conditions. So we need to consider one of the variable as an arbitrary constant. So you can take any of the variable equal to an arbitrary constant. So z will be equal to k, where k is an arbitrary constant. So k can take any value from the domain. So if the domain is the set of real numbers, then k can take any real values, and if the domain is the set of complex numbers, then k can take complex values also. So z is equal to k, an arbitrary constant. After this, we can decide the value of y. So the value of y, if you will put the z equal to k here, then we will get y equal to 8/7 k. And if we will put the value of z and y in the first equation, then we can calculate the value of x. So z is equal to k, so here we will have -2k. Y is equal to 8/7k, so we will have here 24/7k. Now 24/7k -2k, this will be equal to 24 minus 14, so we will get 10k upon 7. So the value of x will be equal to -10k upon 7. So these three values of x, y and z gives us non-zero solutions of the homogeneous system. So if we take, so this solution is a general solution, it represents infinitely many solutions. Now if we take k equal to 7, then we can have a particular solution. So that particular solution will be equal to x equal to -10, y equal to 8 and z equal to 7. And if you want, you can verify by substituting all the values of x, y and z in, you can substitute all the values of x, y and z in terms of k in the given system of linear equations, then you will find that these three values of x, y and z satisfies all the linear equations of the given system. So in this way I have discussed the rules to solve a given homogeneous system of linear equations, and I have discussed all the all types of problems also in case of homogeneous system of linear equations. Homogeneous system of linear equations will be used repeatedly when we will try to find eigenvectors in the next lecture. So after this we will study the topic of eigenvalues and eigenvector. So that part I will discuss in the next lecture.